Hello, I'm Judy Stiles. Thank you for joining us this week on Newsmakers. Our focus this week is recycling, and Joplin has a new operation starting with their trash services recycling. And joining me, Mary Anne Phillips, the recycling coordinator for Joplin. How many times can I say recycling in the first two sentences? But this is something that we've been talking about for a while, and now it's becoming a reality in the city of Joplin.
I've been working towards this for many, many years.
So before we get into the nuts and bolts today and try to answer some questions for people, how it's going to work, a little bit of brief background. It is something that we've talked about in Joplin. You actually had a vote a couple of years ago. How do we get to the point where we're at today?
Well, because the city controls the residential trash, we have the power to put the bid specifications out of what we want that trash service to look like. Mm-hmm. And so we for years, you know, wanted to put it on there, but we knew it would raise the price. And because it was kind of a new idea of the city controlling the trash, so we kind of held back. But then eventually everybody kept asking for it. When it was going to be time to put it on the new bid specs, or even before that, people felt like, well, if Republic Services would offer it, why can't we do it? You know, mm-hmm. why do we even need to wait for, you know, the contract to end? And so the council thought, well, let's see what people will do, because to mandate it or force people to pay for it or to do it, it's not going to work if they don't want to do it.
Right, it's a choice. Right.
Yeah, so we went ahead and put it on the ballot, and it wasn't a binding ballot. It was mm-hmm. just almost more of a survey, if you will. And it did carry in Newton County, and it lost by 5% in Jasper County. And so that told us enough people wanted it, and so we felt like, well, in the next bid specs, you know, we're going to put it in there. Mm-hmm. And if people want it and they're willing to pay for it, then great, we'll do it.
So now we have an option in the city of Joplin to utilize this. And residential, let's define that for people. We're saying it's residential trash service.
Right. In fact, I spoke at an event, and this lady ran up to me. She was so excited. Now I found out she lived in an apartment complex. So it is kind of tricky. Mm-hmm. It's only for residential houses that are single family and duplexes.
Okay.
For years, since 2004, our franchise included multifamily houses or multifamily dwellings, kind of like an apartment house.
Mm-hmm.
Not an apartment complex, but apartment house. And because of curbside recycling and because of the dumpster issue, we just felt like it was going to be simpler to remove those people from the franchise, so those landlords are able to use whatever trash service they want. And that way, too, they can get a dumpster or cart.
They can choose how they want to handle
whatever
the disposal.
Right. And in some cases, it's going to be a little cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
Not in all cases. So this was just going to be easier, less responsibility on the city, too, to manage who's on the franchise. And so, yes, starting, April 1st of 2016, it was just for trashes, just for single family and duplexes.
Right. So people who live in those single family homes or the duplexes now, they have one of those big blue bins that everything goes into.
Mm-hmm.
So if they have one of those, then they're eligible probably for this new service.
Correct.
Tying that together. People are probably curious, a lot of questions I'm sure you're getting as far as how it's going to work, but the bottom line, people will know about the cost, you know. So you say they have the option, so how does the cost factor at?
Well, and you know, that's another thing. You can play with cost all day. Other cities, it's actually cheaper if you have trash and recycling than just trash.
Mm-hmm.
And you see it around the country all different ways.
Right.
But how we landed on it is, if you want this service, because it's an extra service, and so it's $4.75 a month on top of your trash bill. And you have to have trash service. You can't just call in and say, I only want recycling service. You have to have trash.
That's, if you're a Joplin resident, you're required to have that trash service.
Right. Now, if you don't generate trash, well, okay, but you're still being charged for it. So, but then also, $4.75 a month extra may sound like a lot, but because of the way the bids came in, the price for trash is actually lower than what we paid, you know, through
previous,
the past years, previous, you know.
Okay. So the billing is still going to come through the city? And right now we get a bill from the city that includes, I guess, trash and stormwater, right?
Sewer.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah, yes. We will bill for trash and recycling, and mm-hmm. of course we'll continue to do sewer.
Okay.
Wastewater.
So a consolidated bill that will be coming. People also may wonder, what about the days of the week for service? You know, is that going to change? Any of those operational changes?
No, we were adamant about that in the bid specs, that it has to be the same day. Otherwise, it's too confusing. You've got carts out all week. You've got mm-hmm. trucks up and down the streets and alleys. So it has to be the same day.
Okay, so you'll have two carts now, one recycling, one for regular trash, I guess we can call it. Mm-hmm. Then will you have two trucks coming through to pick these items up?
Oh, yes. It will be a different truck that comes through.
Okay. And so the things that you are able to put at the curbside now with your, quote, regular trash, I know you have bulky items, sometimes even TVs and things like that. Mm-hmm. Are those still acceptable for waste?
Oh, yes, yes. We didn't lower any of the things that you could put out there, so you can still put unlimited trash. It doesn't mm-hmm. have to fit in the poly cart. If you have more trash, you can bag it or put it in your own can, or you can ask Republic for another cart. Okay. And then all bulky items can still go out, all mm-hmm. Tree limbs if they're, you know, wrapped up properly, and even leaves and grass if you want. There's no limit on any of that.
Okay. So really, the main change is you now have the option for the recycling cart.
Right.
And when we say recycling cart, there's a separate bin that will be very noticeable and, I guess, marked as a recycling facility.
Well, it's going to be the same color as, mm-hmm. as the trash one, but the lid is light blue.
Okay.
And it says recycling on it, or recyclables. And then the new, if people get a new trash poly cart, the lid will say trash on it.
Okay. So the distribution of these will, as people call in to get the service, they'll get the bins in time to start collecting items, or you know, they'll be dropped off like the early ones were by the department. Or the
right. If you call in early enough, like, you know, about mid-May, mm-hmm. you'll be on that first phase, if you will.
Right.
And so come June 1st, you're guaranteed you'll have a cart and you'll get to start recycling. Now, if you wake up in July and say, you know, I want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then you'll get your cart in hopefully like a business week, and then you'll be able to start. But for that first phase, you know, to get the June 1st going, mm-hmm. we're asking people to call us by May 15th.
So June 1st is the real kickoff date as far as we'll start collecting things as of this point.
Yes, yes.
Right. So people registering, how do they get on that list? You know, they say, okay, I'm interested in this. Mm-hmm. If I want to be able to start putting things in this bin June 1st, what's the process they need to go through?
Well, they need to call Republic Services, mm-hmm. Not the city.
Okay. The people actually doing that?
Yeah. Oh, yes. They have to call Republic Services because they're the ones that are going to keep this master list. They're the ones that know who is going to have a cart and, you know, mm-hmm. and who isn't.
Right.
But also then they also will ask some, you know, very leading questions to make sure you really are inside the city limits.
Okay.
And you really are in a single family or a duplex. So they'll take your name. And then, you know, periodically, you know, daily, weekly, we mm-hmm. haven't worked that out. Then that list will go to the city, and we'll look it up on our list to make sure they're inside the city and it's a single family, and
to verify that they are eligible for it. Right?
And then we'll get back to the trash company, and then when the trash company says, okay, this is the list that qualifies, these two people are mistaken, they're outside city limits, we'll call them back, say, I'm sorry. You know, you're not going to get a cart.
And we had up on the screen, and we also have the phone number now, who to call at Republic. So just you identify yourself as a Joplin resident. I'm sure they'll ask for your address and those confirmation mm-hmm. items to try to think.
And whose name is on the bill okay. is important. Mm-hmm. Like, for instance,
with sometimes my husband, bill, sometimes it's his wife, right?
Yeah, it's my husband's name. It's not mine. And then sometimes the service address is different than the billing address. Okay. So you, before you call, you need to know all that.
So take a look at what you're getting from the city now on your current bill.
Sure, right.
Maybe help you mm-hmm, tie mm-hmm. that together. So you enroll and you get into the program. So you can enroll now even though the service won't start till June. You can pick up a phone and go online, whatever, to get
right.
your name
we're,
on that list.
We're hoping people do. That way Republic knows how many carts to bring into town because mm-hmm. they have to buy these carts. They all have to be assembled and staged and then delivered.
And what's the lead time as far as the bill side of things? So then people get their bills, you know, first of the month or whatever is that? Are they paying in advance for service that month? How do you?
No, all sewer and trash and recycling is what they call pay in arrears.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, for June service, you don't pay for it until July.
First of July after you've used those.
Well,
services.
It's not so much the first. You, mm-hmm. Everybody's different. We
right,
have a lot of
billing
different cycles.
Days, right.
Mm-hmm. right.
So if they sign up for June 1st, they may not see it on their bill till the July bill comes
correct.
In and tying that together. Well, I know there's a lot of items that people have been going to the recycling center for years that you have in the city of Joplin. So part of your role, I'm sure, is the education. What can go in this bin? What can't?
It's going to be a little confusing at first because, believe it or not, there's things on the curbside that they have that I don't at the recycling center mm-hmm. and vice versa. So it's going to be a lot of education for people.
But up front, the recycling center is staying open. You're going to be in business
oh,
in the
yes,
recycling
yes,
center.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Because we still have to serve those multifamily dwellings right. and the apartment mm-hmm. complexes, the businesses, students, people from out of town.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we get them from all over the place.
Yeah. Well, let's take some time for the audience to kind of explain the do's and the don'ts, what you have. And I guess in front of you, one of the big things we think about recycling is plastic. So let's start with talking about that, and then we'll have a demonstration to show some of the items we have in the bin.
Plastic is the hardest thing. And I apologize up front, at the recycling center, we only take number one and number two, you know, it's a bottle, you mm-hmm. know, with the neck. And there's no way you're going to be able to see this on TV, but if you look on the bottom of most any plastic bottle or cup or container, it's going to be on the bottom or it's going to be on the side. And so for curbside, we'll take numbers 1 through 5, mm-hmm. you skip over 6, and then we take number 7s for curbside.
So for the curbside, if you're going to have this bin, check that plastic container and see what the number is. Mm-hmm. So 6 is not acceptable.
Sample of a 6 is a styrofoam cooler, a styrofoam cup, styrofoam egg carton, mm-hmm. is usually a number 6.
Okay.
Not always, and it's not always marked either. Now this particular one is clearly marked, it says 6 on the bottom. And so you cannot do this at curbside.
Okay, so 1 through 5 and then number 7 bottles and so forth. Now we have a bin, so as we're talking, one of our student volunteers, Megan, is going to kind of help us out and show us what we have. First of all, of course, people will be able to see the cart, and the cart with this light blue lid, and I don't know if Megan, you can reach over and kind of show everybody that lid that we have so we can show them the color of the lid and see how the color is definitely a different color.
It's
lid.
It's different. And then it says recyclables on the lid, mm-hmm. in white.
Okay, so let's go through some of the items we've set out on the table next to it, and really, as you can see, quite a variety of plastics as you go in there. So start tossing things in as she talks about them.
Okay, now this is interesting because some syrups and some ketchups are number 1 or 2, and there's even 5s and 7s. Mm. So what's great is it doesn't matter. Throw it in there.
So it can go in there. The main thing is keep it clean. You have to wash them out.
Yeah, because you don't want your bin getting yucky. Yeah. That's probably a number 2, and it really doesn't matter on the color either. A lot of people get confused. Oh, do you only take clear? So toss it
in there.
So bleach is kind of easy. A lot of detergents, I don't know that there's any that aren't a number 2. They're real easy to recycle.
But these are things you're not taking now at the recycling center.
Take the 3, 4, 5, 7, mm-hmm. and we don't take them with lids. So see, she threw that in
the
there
lid
with
was fine.
The lid.
Mm-hmm.
Throw it in with the lid. Now, ketchup is a good example. Sometimes if you look on the bottom, it'll say, you know,
have a
5 or 7, mm-hmm. and that's fine. Okay,
another there's detergent one without bottle. The lid, can
we
go
don't
right
care.
In there.
Throw it in there. All colors, get it in there.
So color doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be clear plastic.
Now this is the exciting part. Aerosol cans. Oh. I cannot believe they're going to take aerosol cans.
So you're emptying
Please
spray can.
Please make sure they're empty. Please, yeah, spray can. That probably was a number 7. That's why we put that in there.
Now this part of the plastic.
This is exciting too. We're also going to be taking cups and tubs and containers like that, as long as it has a 1 through. You know,
so all these little 7. Souvenir cups, they get beat up. You have a place to put them now.
My Mardi Gras cup just went in. A solo cup. You know, how many people have solo
plastic
cups?
Solo cups and
disposables. One of my Mardi Gras cups. I'm going to fish that back out.
Right.
Okay. And then see, this is kind of a tub kind of thing, and that's unusual. Same with
plastic ice cream containers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So those plastic margarine tubs, the plastic things that hold frosting, all those different things are going there now.
Yeah, yogurt, butter. And then, of course, cardboard's easy to differentiate. And then also I had a piece of chipboard in there. Some people call it fiberboard. Mm-hmm. So that could all go in there. Exciting, aluminum pans and aluminum foil as well as aluminum cans.
Okay.
So, and then medicine bottles, usually, you know, those are a 5 or a 7.
So they're a harder plastic, but they'll still go in there.
But I would suggest everybody take the labels off. Mm-hmm. Believe it or not, it's another aerosol can, another spray can. And of course,
the traditional soda cans,
that's
right?
Easy to figure out. And of course, steel and tin cans, that's pretty easy.
And none of this is sorted, it just all goes in that one container.
There's no sorting to it. All kinds of paper, telephone books, office paper, junk mail, envelopes, catalogs.
The paper sacks.
Paper sacks, office paper, your kids' homework,
and of course the newspaper. So all of this goes in the bin, and you can just collect it up over the week, or maybe you have 2 weeks before you get enough to push it to the curb, and then you're ready to go out.
Yeah, and you don't have to put it out every week if you don't want to.
So have that gathered together, and she was putting things in there and just kind of piles it in there, and then someone else's job to sort it for us.
Right. Then it'll go to a place here in Joplin, and they will bale it. So they won't sort it.
Okay.
It'll just get literally dumped on the floor. We call it a tipping floor, and then they'll put it into their baler. Now, if they see something that absolutely should not go in there, or it's dangerous or contaminated, they'll pull it out. But they'll bale it, and then once they get a truckload, it will go to a place in Springfield. Then they have very sophisticated machinery that will sort it.
Okay, so that's where they can pull out the plastics and the papers and the different things that
right.
are involved in that design. Now, we also have some demonstration of items that you won't take on the curbside. So let's talk about what's on the small table down there at the bottom.
Well, glass bottles. And I'm sorry, folks. The place in Springfield doesn't take glass, but we'll still take glass at the recycling center.
Okay.
I realize there are some curbside programs in the United States that do take glass, but it when it breaks, it contaminates the rest of the materials, and it just adds to the cost. So we felt like we weren't ready to fight that battle right now. We were just going to,
You're dependent
glass.
On your regional service for that.
Sure, right. Sure. But that's not to say it couldn't change, years from now. Styrofoam is still, very difficult to recycle, especially in this market. So we're not taking any styrofoam, which includes the egg cartons or clamshell,
like take-home boxes.
Take-home
right.
boxes, yeah. Of course, glass, any Pyrex, any ceramic, any plate, drinking glasses, obviously you can't put it in there. Can't put hardback books in there. Ribbon, and bows, because that really gets tangled up.
So if they have sorting machinery, it would really tear up the machinery. Right.
And plastic bags. Plastic bags, shopping bags or what the newspaper comes in, those really get messed up in the automated systems too, in the sorting systems. So we won't take those. And the microwave trays, I'm not sure why, but we can't take those either.
It's a different type of plastic involved that they can't recycle
right,
as easily
right,
and
right.
tying that together. Now, the boxes we saw go in the bin earlier, do you need to try to flatten them? Is it easier to fit them in there if we flatten things, or is that required to be flattened? Or?
Well, they're asking that the cardboard be flattened down or disassembled. That way, bottles don't get in the box,
right.
and then it's harder for the sorters.
Okay, so if you got something in the mail, one of your mail order things, just smash that box down before you toss it in the box and tying that together. So we go to the facility for recycling in Springfield, and then from there, these things go on to live another life, as far as...
Right, and they know who their markets are, who they may sell it to a broker, or they may sell it directly to a manufacturer. For instance, there's a place in Springfield that makes cat litter out of old newspapers.
Okay.
So, they may sell bales of newspaper directly to them. Or it may go clear to China. Whatever the market's bearing at that time.
Right. So, but for Joplin's Recycling Center, you're still going to be there. And for people who don't live in the city of Joplin, you have those options. But people who might have glass bottles, I live in the city, I can't put that glass bottle in there. I can still save those back and drive across town and drop them
off. Oh, sure, sure. Or talk your neighbor into carpooling your glass over, we'll still take glass, and of course we'll take batteries, household hazardous waste, styrofoam packing peanuts, hardback books, cooking oil. There's just so many other things that we take that you're never going to be able to put
at a curbside center. Now we have a website up for the city, and that's an easy reference for people as we're talking, as far as where can we find out more specifics in the city of Joplin's website, recycling and trash, and you can look at the many different links. The recycling center, I know we've talked about it in the past, that you've really seen an increase in, I guess, business or customers over the years.
Oh, yes. We get a lot of people who, unfortunately, burn their trash out in the country. And so, they'll bring things to us. We have a lot of businesses. We see traveling sales reps who give, hand out cards to their customers. And when they're out of date, they bring them to us, or cardboard boxes that their samples come in.
Mm-hmm.
You never know who's gonna
generate some waste.
Right.
And the reference they had up there, as far as you have a recycling brochure, but also online, a lot of ideas you don't think about. What to do with those old batteries? The household hazardous waste. Define what that involves.
Well, some people call it chemicals, but it could be dry, it could be semi-solid, but anything that has to do with fixing your car or your house. Insecticides, pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers. We take everything except paint. And paint is just so expensive. that then it eat up all my money that I wouldn't have to get rid of mercury, which is very difficult.
Very hazardous.
Mm-hmm. So, but we have on the website and at the recycling center, we tell people how they can solidify their paint and then just set it out for the trash company.
So once the paint's a solid hot block, it can go into the trash. Into the waste. Electronics?
We still take electronics. Another thing you're not going to see at a curbside program. Mm-hmm. We recently had to start charging for old-fashioned televisions. Mm-hmm. So we charge $7, and they can pay if they have cash or credit card, they go to the city hall. If they have a check or money order, they can come directly to the recycling center. And it's, you know, the old analog or
great big heavy cart.
If it has a big hump on the back, you can guarantee it's going to be $7.
Right. So as people are still updating to the thinner new flat screen TVs, there are still a lot of those that have to get into a waste system.
Oh, I still use my analogs at my house, you know. Mm-hmm. They work.
As long as they keep working, we're using
them.
Right. But those can go to the recycling center. Are they still acceptable curbside as well? People can set them out with their trash?
Right. And that's kind of confusing because electronics are not banned from Missouri landfills yet, okay. Unless you're a business, you're and generating a lot. Excuse me.
Mm-hmm. So we're looking at a lot of different options. People need to be aware that, you know, where are these things going as they're being trashed? Or, you know,
right. Now, if you put a television or a computer at the curb with your trash, is going to go to the Lamar landfill. It will not get recycled.
And that was another question. People wonder, where does Joplin's trash go? Ends up down the highway to Lamar?
Well, it depends. Mm-hmm. If the truck has just trash in it, then yes, it goes to Lamar landfill. But if it's mixed in with yard waste, if it's mixed in with bags of leaves and grass and tree limbs, then it can't go to Lamar because it's banned from Missouri landfills since 1990. And so it ends up going to the Kansas landfill.
Okay. So which way your direction? Mm-hmm. But Joplin will still accept those leaves, bags of leaves and bags of grass clippings and so forth at the side of the road.
Yes, as it stands now, unless
the state passes some new laws,
or Lamar does. Mm-hmm. But we try to encourage people to go to our compost facility for leaves and grass, and that way we can make compost out of it.
And tell us where that's at for somebody who's watching.
Well, it's kind of, it's not easy to find. Yes. You go north on Schifferdecker all the way, and then when it comes to a T, you go left on, Peace Church Avenue.
Right. And so there's a big location there where people are dropping off the limbs, the tree leaves, those types of things.
Right. You go to the Turkey Creek Wastewater Treatment Plant.
Okay.
If you get that far, you found it.
Right. And then I know in the past you used to also provide another use for those by giving people a chance to pick up compost. Do you still do that in the city?
It's out there. It's out there now.
So if
people can go get it, but it's self-serve. You have to shovel it yourself.
All right. So if you're looking for some spring gardening, you have that compost ready to help with the gardens and enhancing them and tying that together. So so as we've been talking, a big part of what you're working with is just educating the public. We have a flyer or a handout that you're handing out to people with information, just answering those questions over the next couple of months.
Yeah, at different venues we'll have these cards, but also people will be getting them in the mail too. Republic is mailing them directly to their houses.
Mm-hmm. So if you are a Joplin resident right now getting trash service, there should be a lot of opportunities to get information on what to do with this next step.
Right. And there's no real deadline.
Mm-hmm. So if you don't sign up by June 1st, you can turn around and say later that month, well, that's not a bad idea. Maybe we should try it. Right. Now, one thing that I remember when Joplin started using the blue carts for the trash service, those stay with the address of the house. So if you move, you leave those behind.
Right. And they're the property of Republic.
Okay. So if you move and you're paying for both recycling and trash, it's up to the new owners to decide what they're going to cover and what they're going to do.
Right. Yeah. So if they decide they don't want curbside recycling, then Republic will come get that cart.
Right. Now, I know in the past, Republic, you had to call if you had big items. I think they even take like mattresses, great big things like that. Mm-hmm. Do you need to call in advance if you're going to have something oversized like that?
No, they kind of realized that it wasn't necessary. At first, when we got the automated trucks, the arm that goes out, right. Some of those trucks really weren't set up to get bulky items, so they were afraid that they would have to send in another truck. As it turned out, not that many people put bulky items out, but then also they started getting the trucks that have a big container on the front of the truck.
Kind of a dumpster on the front that dumps it to the back.
Right. So, you know, through the years, it became unnecessary to call ahead.
Okay. Well, this being spring cleaning time, a lot of people might be going through that garage, going through the house, getting rid of some of those bigger things that you have to look for how to get rid of it.
Right.
But if you have any questions, the best choice is check your website.
And you can, you know, and you can still, if you have some bulky items, you're not real sure if they will take, you know, go ahead and call them. They have a whole bank of people and they sit in Springfield. That's what they do. They answer the phone.
Answer those questions for
you.
Yeah,
they don't sit in India. They sit in Springfield, Missouri.
So local people who know what you're talking about. Right. And then the times when we do have, you know, storms that take down a lot of tree limbs and branches, the city may have some special pickups for those. I know you've had those in the past.
It has to rise to a certain level before we'll stop, you know, and the street department, sometimes even parks, will go out and pick up the limbs, or we'll open up the city's 40 acres, that's what we call it, the 40, up on Schifferdecker, and we'll open it up so people can bring them up there. But that's just, you know, on a weather-related, case-by-case basis.
Kind of an emergency situation when we have some situations. In the meantime, if you have those branches, you're doing your spring cleaning, they need to be cut a certain length and then tied together so people can handle
them. Yes, it's a bit of a hassle, and they can't be more than 50 pounds. But actually, we do open up the tree limb site the third Saturday of every month. Mm. Between March and November.
Okay.
So people can bring them to the site up on North Schifferdecker, third Saturday of the month between 8 and 2.
During those work seasons, for free. Right. Okay, well, I know you've got a big challenge getting this word out, but the city's been working toward this. Citizens have been asking for it for quite a while. What has your initial reaction been from people when you're talking to them?
Well, a little bit of everything. You know, they call and they go, oh, I grew up in such and such city. I've only known curbside. And then I moved to Joplin and I was like, what? You know, I get those calls from people who are used to it where they used to live. So they're happy. I get others that say, well, it's about time, you know, and
they're ready for it.
They're ready to sign up. But then I have others who, and some dear friends who have said, you know, I generate a lot of glass. I still have to go to the recycling center.
So I'll just keep driving everything to the recycling.
And I'm like, there's no right or wrong answer. You just do what fits your family.
So time to assess your needs, what you have, and what's going on. And the recycling information, once again, is on the City of Joplin's website, joplinmo.org/recycling. So you can find out that.
Yes, now you don't have to go through all of the other departments and pages. If you type that in, you'll go right to the recycling page.
Right, for a lot of information. Well, Mary Anne, I'd like to thank you, and then we have on the screen the Joplin Republic Services as well that shows people, you know, where they can go to try to get that call place to put me on the list.
I think that's really the takeaway is just call Republic. They know all the ins and outs and the rules and the cost, and they can answer everything.
Right. So there's really a partnership between Republic and the city in trying to get this program up and running. Feedback from the citizens and questions are where you're coming in to try to make it work.
And people are still, obviously, they're welcome to call me with, with any question, but it's faster for curbside, at least, recycling, to call them directly.
Well, thank you very much for being with us today and answering questions for the viewers and Joplin citizens. And we've been saying, and one more time, this is for Joplin residents.
Right, that live in a single-family house or a duplex.
Within the city limits of Joplin.
Right.
All right, well, thank you for being here today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I'd like to thank you, the viewers, for joining us this week on Newsmakers. I'm Judy Stiles. Hope you can join me again next week at the same time on the station. We'll see you then.